Hi guys, this is Harish Bali from technofare.com. Do you want to send personalized emails? Or is your requirement bulk email for official or personal use? Now, do you want something that's free also? And a mail body should have possibility of adding multiple variables? If the answer to all these questions is yes, then you are at the right tutorial. I'm going to explain you how to use mail merge in Gmail. There are three good to know reasons why you should use Gmail mail merge. First, it's free and you can send up to 100 mails in a day. Second good reason is you can send mails to a group of people in one go. Third reason is you can use multiple variables. We'll talk about this and much more. So when can you use mail merge? If there is a function at home or there is a party, there is an official meeting, there is a college festival or just about anything for which you need to send bulk personalized emails. Three things which are needed to do mail merge. First is you need the message that you want to send, which is quite obvious. Second thing is you need the mail IDs in a group in Gmail. Well, you need the mail IDs, but in a group is important. Third thing is you need a reliable app that can do this job for you. Let's get going. This is the draft message that I have prepared for the purpose of this tutorial. Keep the two field blank. Enter the subject garden party this weekend in this example. This is the first variable I have used, hey, first name. If you look carefully, the first variable has been mentioned with the less than equal to brackets. There are two brackets before and two brackets at the end. Then I am throwing a cool party this weekend at my farmhouse. I would like you to come and have fun, some fun together. All of our friends are coming, so I expect you to this weekend, Saturday at time. Now again, this is the second variable, and before the second variable and after the end of the second variable, there are two brackets which are less than and equal to sign. What can happen is you can send invites to various people for different timings, which I will show you when we actually go and draft the message. I have prepared a test folder for the purpose of this demonstration, and these are my four friends. You can have up to 100 because this app allows you to send 100 emails in one go in a day. So this is the second thing which I wanted to show you. Third thing, what you need to do is open Google Drive. So there are two ways. One is open a new tab and type drive.google.com. Another way is click on this button and go to Google Drive. It will open in a separate window. Once you are at Google Drive, you need to click on create button and go to spreadsheet. Spreadsheet will open in another window. The add-on that I'm going to use for this is yet another mail merge, which is a reliable app. Click on add-ons. Since I already have yet another mail merge installed on my Google Docs, so I will not need to install another one, but I'll explain you how to do it in your spreadsheet. You will not need to go get add-ons. Once you are on this sheet, this similar window will open. Click on yet another mail merge. Enter. So in my case, it is showing manage because I already have it here. But in your case, it will show you an option to install. Just click on the option and it will automatically install on Google Docs. Once you install yet another mail merge, go to add-ons again and you will see yet another mail merge the way I am seeing it here. Then click on start mail merge. This is showing working. Yet another mail merge. If you are doing it for the first time, it will ask you to authenticate, and from the next time it will show similar window like this. Select the group. In my case, the group name is test, and click on import contacts. So the contacts of the group will get imported here with the first full name, first name, last name, okay, and the email address and the company. Now I click on this particular D column and insert a column here and mention time. Now what is more important to look here and understand is if I mention time as time with t as small, this would be wrong. It will not work. I have mentioned time with t capital in my subject, so I must enter t capital. Now if I wish to invite the, now if I want my mail to go as 5 p.m. then I should select this particular column, go to format, number, and check the plain text option and write 5 p.m. here. Let's say I want to invite the other person at 6 p.m., then 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. This is just for the purpose of this demonstration that I'm entering different names. This is my own mail ID, baliharish@hotmail.com. So what I am going to do next is click on add-ons again, click on yet another mail merge, and then click on start mail merge. You will see yet another mail merge is checking it out. Message, this is the subject of the message. You can write the sender name here. Let's say my friends, they call me Rocky. So I click on Rocky and click on send email. You also have got choice to send a test mail before you actually send it to people. So let me click on send mails. All emails have been sent, and can you see this notification? All the emails have been sent, the date and the time, and there's an email send notification which is coming, and this is my Hotmail inbox, and there's a one mail that has come. Let's check. Okay, can you see the sender name as Rocky? This is subject, garden party this weekend. Okay, let us check out the details. I am throwing a cool party this weekend at my farmhouse, and the name, first name that was addressed was Hey Hari. Okay, let's go and see. Hey Hari, that's right. Other thing is, I would like you to come and have some fun together. All our friends are coming, so I expect you to this weekend, Saturday at 6 p.m. So the time that I mentioned was 6 p.m. That's also right. Hope that's fine, and the image is also looking great. I hope you guys have enjoyed watching this tutorial, and it makes a lot of sense to use Gmail mail merge for official and personal use. Do subscribe to this channel for more tech related stuff. Thanks for watching.